happy morning to all my dear children. Welcome back to your computer class. Dear children, we were studying your chapter number 1, that is evolution of computers. Today we are going to move to part 3 of this chapter. In our last video lesson, we have studied about the first generation's computer. Yes, and we have studied the examples as well. That was Mark 1, UNIVAC. Yes, dear children, do you remember it? Very good. Today, we are going to move forward and to see the second generation computers that were from 1956 to 63. Here, in the second generation computers, we are having some characteristics. Let us see. Now, first of all, they were smaller in size and faster as well as compared to the first generation computer. Dear children, as we will move on to the next generation computers, there will be only the comparison between the previous and the current generation. Like now, in this second generation computers, we are doing the comparison with the first one. Okay? Because there was a development. Yes. Because of the second generation computers. So, we will compare the things. In the first one, as you can see, the second generation computers were faster and were smaller in size as compared to the first generation computer. They were more reliable also as compared to the first generation computers. They had many components. Now, the second generation computers have some components such as printer, memory, disk storage, operating system, etc., which were associated with the modern day computers. Yes, now also we are seeing the printer, the hard disk, each and every these components we are seeing as well nowadays. So, they are more associated with the modern day computers as well. Transistors were used as the main component. In our first class, in our first generation computers, we have studied that there were vacuum tubes used as a main component. You remember? Yes. In the second generation computers, we are using transistors as the main component. I will show you the picture of transistors as well. They might be looking like the fork. Okay. जो फॉग जिससे हम मैगी खाते हैं, यस नूडल्स खाते हैं, दे माइट बी लुकिंग अ सिमिलर लाइक इट. ओके, सी द टाइप ऑफ द ट्रांजिस्टर्स. नेक्स्ट, दे वर इजियर टू प्रोग्राम देन द फर्स्ट जनरेशन कंप्यूटर, सो दे हैड ग्रेटर कमर्शियल यूज. दे वर वेरी मच इजियर टू यूज एज वेल. द प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज सच एज COBOL and FORTRAN came into use during this time. You don't have to learn the names. You have to just understand these were the two programming languages that were being used in the second generation computers. Yes. Next, this you have to learn. What are the examples of second generation computer? That is IBM 1401 and ATLAS. These two are the examples of second generation computers. Is it clear? What were the characteristics? First of all, they were very faster and smaller in size, and they were very much easier to use. Then transistors were the main component in the second generation computers, and the two examples which we have studied, that is IBM 1401 and ATLAS. Moving on to next, third generation computers. Another development was there in the field of computers. After second generation, there was third generation computers from 1964 to 71. The third generation computers were smaller as compared to the second generation computer. Wo aur bhi chote the as compared to the second one. Now, some characteristics. What was the main component of the third generation computer? That are the integrated circuits. You can say ICS, integrated circuits. Is it clear? Was the main component component in the third generation computer, which was popularly called chips. The integrated circuit is also called a silicon chip. What is the another name of integrated circuit? That is silicon chip. Clear? I will show you the picture. This is a type of an integrated circuit which were being used in the third generation computers. Next, the third generation computers were very smaller and cheaper. Means very smaller and were very much less expensive as compared to the second one. They were fast and more reliable. High level language was developed. The language was developed where it was very higher. With magnetic core and solid state main storage, greater storage capacity was developed. As compared to the second generation computer, in the third generation, we were having the greater storage capacity. They were able to reduce the computational time and had low maintenance cost. The maintenance cost was very less. As well as whatever the time is required to do the work on the computers, the computational time was also very less as compared to the second one. Input and output devices became more sophisticated. Now, next, what are the two examples of the third generation computer? You have to remember this. IBM 360 and IBM 370 are the two examples for the second generation computers. What were the characteristics? First of all, the integrated circuits were the main components, which were popularly known as chips. And what is the another name for that? That is silicon chip. They were faster, they were smaller in size, they were more reliable, as well as they were very cheaper compared to the second generation computer. Then these are the two examples which we are having, that is IBM 360 and IBM 370. Dear children, I hope you are clear with the two generations of computers, okay? The second and the third. Now let's see a small worksheet based on this video lesson. Worksheet based on chapter 1 part 3. What you have to do? Fill in the blanks using the help box given below. Help box is also given to you. What you have to do? You have to solve this worksheet in your computer notebook. Copy the questions as well. Dash were used as a main component in second generation computer. You know the answer very well. You have to just choose it from here. Dash were used as a main component in third generation computers. Then, dash and dash are the examples of second generation computers. The two examples which you have to write. The integrated circuit is also called as dash. What was the another name for integrated circuit? Dash and dash are the examples of third generation computers. Dear children, I hope you are very much clear with these two generations. We will meet next time to see more interesting in this chapter. Till then, bye-bye. God bless you all.